a joint venture with your national champion, Yare. It is called Abyss Helicopter Romania, which is a worldwide center of excellence for maintenance, repair, and overhaul of helicopters, and very specialized in the Puma, Super Puma family. Abyss Helicopter Romania handles aircraft coming from all over the world. And there's the industrial project, which we have inaugurated in 2016 when French President Hollande came to Brașov. Unfortunately, this project is still in the infant stage. We built this facility. We started to transfer some toolings and equipment in order to be able to launch rapidly the production of H215M, which is the third generation of Super Pumas, in comparison to the Pumas currently operated here, which are first generation ones. H215M will be produced in Brașov. I call it H215M, but actually it should be called Yare 215M, because what we will do is first, this new factory, the building exists, we just need to transfer the equipment to start the industrial activity. We will manufacture the helicopter in the most basic configuration. Then it will be transferred to our neighbor, physical neighbor, Yare, where the aircraft will be customized as per the Romanian MOD requirements. And to be very honest with you, Yare's portion, industrially speaking, is at least as important as the first phase of manufacturing the helicopter. And Yare would be the prime contractor with the Ministry of Defense. So it's a made in Romania helicopter sold by a Romanian company to the Romanian government for the Romanian armed forces to defend Romanian population. This is what I call a made in Romania solution. And no one can offer a similar solution. We're very clear. Romania has to lead by example. And to kickstart this industrial project, we hoped, we expected that the Romanian Ministry of Defense would place an initial order for H215Ms, because the Puma Sokat, no matter how great they are getting very, very old and will have to be replaced in the near future. So this was one of the prerequisites to launch the industrial project. As no contract was awarded to Airbus Helicopters, to H215M contracts, we had to put it on hold. One of my key arguments is the following. 215s will be manufactured in Romania. If Romania doesn't buy these helicopters, how credible can it be in the export market? So we continue to manufacture the H215M in Marignan, in our main plant in the south of France. We continue to sell it very well, but it is not made in Romania. It is made in France. And since 2016, we've sold between 40 to 50 of such helicopters. And it's a missed opportunity, because in 2016, we're ready to launch the full-fledged project, meaning that all these helicopters we have sold, including some to neighbor countries, these helicopters would be either in production right now in Brașov or about to be produced. And that would be about 3 years of production forecast for the Romanian factory. So we evaluate that 40 to 50 helicopters will have to be replaced. We were very flexible. We understood that there were budget constraints. We said, look, if 40 is too much in one shot, let's agree on a smaller quantity, but we need a critical mass. And the critical mass was 16, which makes sense from an industrial point of view, but also from an operational point of view. Unfortunately, it never became a reality. I mean, it's a pity that since the inauguration of the plant 3 years ago, nothing has happened.
If Romanian authorities don't decide to do this, and there is this risk that Airbus will leave the factory here and go somewhere else where you have new contract.
There is a risk, clearly. Airbus Helicopter Romania, our joint venture with Brașov, is a success story. It is part of the Airbus Helicopter ecosystem. So I would say, you know, this is not in danger. But the industrial project, yes, it could really be a missed opportunity. Why keep something that does not exist yet? The building exists, but it is not producing helicopters. So as long as it's okay for us to continue to build it in France, we're fine. The day we need to make logistic decision or getting some more space for other projects, then we will need to make a decision. And either it will be a very positive decision and we will launch the project here, which is my ambition, my genuine ambition, or simply we will agree with another country which shows a very strong commitment in ordering enough aircraft and will also benefit from worldwide order, because this is an important point. This factory in Brașov is not only for Romanian orders, it is for worldwide orders. Just to give you some rough numbers, we estimate that the production could be 15 helicopters per year. Okay? So we don't expect to build 15 helicopters for Romania every year, year after year. But let's say with the first order of 16, we could very well say that year one we produce 5, then 5, then 6, for instance. Meaning that you have 10 open spots for production. How are we going to fill that? Well, any country in the world ordering H215M or H215 civilian version would have a made in Romania helicopter. We've been for the last few years sponsoring students in a college in the Brașov region. And now we are over 200. They want to have a future in aerospace. We thought that with such industrial project, we would guarantee them a job in Brașov with Airbus to develop the Romanian industry. What are we going to do? A lot of them are going to graduate, and unless there's this project, they will maybe export what they've learned and work in other aerospace companies, maybe Airbus, by the way, but outside of Romania. Yes, we will hire some, but unless there is a project, not as many as we would have liked to. And this is a pity. And this, again, is a missed opportunity. The first question that must be asked is, what is an attack helicopter? Is it a 100% dedicated attack helicopters which cannot do anything else? Is it a multi-purpose helicopters adapted with specific equipment to become also an attack helicopters, but it's not a dedicated one? Or you have some sort of hybrid solution which is smaller than a multi-purpose helicopter, has the capability of an attack helicopter, but can also transport special forces, different type of loads. And this is maybe a solution that should be looked at. And when I talk about this, I'm thinking more specifically about the H145M, which can do much, much more than just an attack helicopter. So yes, we heard clearly that there was an intention also to acquire attack helicopters. We will compete. We believe we have a rather interesting value proposition. On one hand, much cheaper than a dedicated attack helicopter, but also offering much more flexibility than an attack helicopter. I see the H145M as a Swiss knife, basically. It does everything and rather well. If we really look at the region and the neighboring countries, the market has been very active since 2 years now, 2.5 years. Serbia has bought some H215s as well as H145M. We have delivered actually the first H145M very recently. Hungary has made the decision to buy also some Super Pumas, but the H225M version, which is the a little bit larger version, the one operated by the French Special Forces, as well as a fleet of H145M. So as you can see, there is an operational synergy in the region. I see our project as a project of national interest for Romania, because we will create high-value jobs, hundreds of immediate high-value jobs, plus additional hundreds of indirect jobs. I don't know if you know that, but we have, thanks to our activity, Airbus activity in Romania, 6,300 direct and indirect jobs created because of our activities here. This is very important, okay? We've paid over 30 million in social taxes. We consider ourselves as a Romanian citizen, and we want to expand that. But there must be a contract to kickstart this industrial project. It takes two to tango. We're on the dance floor since a few years.